That you will succeed. So don't just do the thing there. if you are studying, don't just say that, let me try, let me also study. Decide, program your mind that you will succeed. And I see you succeeding in the name of Jesus. That will also explain to you that you have to educate yourself. So any area that you find yourself, you have to educate yourself. Get understanding in the area that you are doing. If it is marriage that you are going through, get understanding. Get to know the person you are getting married to. Don't just follow love, follow wisdom, follow understanding. If you follow love to enter into anything, it will bring you down. So you have to educate yourself. What are the things that I need to embark on the journey? What are the qualities? What are the things I have to be qualified for so that I can be successful? If it is ministry, you don't just say that God has called me, therefore I want to start a church. You must educate yourself. Go to Bible school, seek the face of God, read books, get books, read Bible, get knowledge about ministry. If it is secular, get knowledge. You want to open a restaurant, get knowledge. Don't just allow love to push you. Another word for love is desire. Don't just allow only desire to move through, but get knowledge, get understanding. So Bible says that in all you're getting, get wisdom and get understanding. So you must educate yourself. Hosea chapter 4, it says, there's a profound scripture there. I want to read to you, then we move on. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Bible says that for lack of knowledge, my people are perished. So in all you're getting, get knowledge, get wisdom, educate yourself, know what you are doing. And people will look at you and then they'll know that you are doing something extraordinary. I pray for you that you will not just be following the crowd, but you get understanding in every area that you want to. If it is business, you get understanding. If it is politics, you get understanding. If it is education, you get understanding. If it is marriage, you get understanding. If it is ministry, you get understanding. You get understanding in every area. If you want to prophesy, you get understanding. If you want to preach, every area that you want to do in life, there is a route for you to be educated or to educate yourself. This morning, I want to talk to you about how to develop the ultimate success attitude. How to develop the ultimate success. How to develop the attitude of a successful person. Huh? How to develop the attitude. For you to be successful, you must have an attitude. And this is what we have been talking. So, how to develop a successful attitude. Or how to develop an attitude of a successful person. How to develop it? Because you can't just get up and say you want to be an engineer. Then you just get up and you started say, God has called me to be an engineer. So you are an engineer. Or God has called me to be a pilot. Do you want me to be your pilot? The way you look at me, you go to an airport, and then as you're about to enter the plane, you see me. Then I will shake you and say, bro, I'm your pilot. You quickly get down because so far as you are concerned, I have no knowledge about being piloting. So you have to get the how to develop or how to enter or how to be successful in the attitude of a willing person is very, very important. So knowledge is important, but this morning, how to develop it. And remember that I'm speaking to you in the point of God's way. How God wants to prosper you. How God wants to direct you. How God wants to energize you. How God wants to bring you into the place of power and into the place of victory. So how to develop a successful attitude. For you to be successful, there must be an attitude. For you to be successful, there must be a behavior. For you to be a successful, you don't just get down and then just say, I'm coming to do it. There is a way, there is a path, there is a road, there is something you should do. So, as today is Sunday morning, I didn't just get up and then put on my uniform and say that I am coming to preach. There are certain things I develop. There are certain things I have already done it. There are things, there are people, there are a lot of things I've done this morning. So, how to develop a successful attitude? Person. Number one. Thank you, Lord. Mabirema Duma Asi Amaye successful attitude, you must know God personally. You must know God personally. And through intimacy in the scriptures. So you must know God by knowing the scriptures. You must know God by knowing the scriptures. I am speaking to you how to develop a successful attitude. How to develop it. You must know God through the scriptures. You must have intimacy with God through understanding the scripture. Ladies and gentlemen, nobody has ever seen God before. Do you know the color of God's shirt? Do you know the height of God? Do you know the color of God? Do you know the food that God eats? Do you know the room of God? You don't have the idea about God. You can never know God personally. So you have to develop. You have to know. You have to develop an intimacy by reading the scripture. And as we are reading the scriptures, you begin to know God. We know God by reading the scripture. As we read it, we know Him. How do you know somebody? You read about the person. And as you are reading the Bible, you know that God is a God of love. You know that God can prosper you. You know that God can kill all your enemies. You know that God can make you make it. You know that God can God is willing. You know the mind of God as you are reading the scriptures. Matthew chapter 6. Verse 30. Thank you, Lord. Bible 6. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall He not much more clothe you, O ye little faith? So you have to understand that when we are talking of to know God, you must know that God is able, God is capable, God can clothe you. He says that, wherefore, if God can clothe the grass of the field, if God can clothe them, which you see today, why God can't clothe also you? It means that God can feed you. It means that God can increase you. It means that God can bring you into the place of your faith. He says that, therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father, knowing that you need all these things, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. So as we read the scriptures, we know God, that God can clothe me, God can cover me, God can be with me. As you begin to read the scriptures, you begin to know that you don't need to disturb yourself, you don't need to worry yourself, you don't need to fight for yourself, but God can fight for you. So ability to have a successful attitude, ability to move on with your successful life, you must know God. If you can't know God through scriptures, you are just walking, just moving just like that. But once you know God, there is a strong edge, there is a strong faith, there is something that binds you. You can never be moved because you have read the Bible, and Bible says that He can clothe you, He can increase you. Therefore, you can seek Him. As you are seeking God, He will act, 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 He will act. We are not serving the God of depreciation, but we are serving the God of increase. So as you begin to seek God personally, He will add everything. That's why Bible says that seek Him first, the kingdom of heaven and His righteousness, and everything that you need. So you must know God personally through reading the scriptures. 2 Timothy chapter 3. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Verse 16. Thank you, Lord. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Let's read here the word of God. It says that all scriptures is given by inspiration of God. You must know God personally through reading the scriptures. One of the problem of our days is we don't want to read the scripture. We want to be prophesied to. We want to dance. We want to jump. But we don't want to know God personally. Our days, we just go to church, but we don't know Christ. We don't know the God that we are serving. We know men of God, but we don't know God of men. We know the men of God, but we don't know the God of men. So,
scriptures, you begin to know God. But in our generation, we don't want to read scriptures. We don't have time. We want to watch home videos. We want to watch YouTube. We want to play Facebook. We want to go Instagram. We want to dance. We want to shout. We want to do certain things. But all these things can never make you know God. If you want to know God personally, then you must recognize that forever, oh Lord, that when a circle, it is circle in heaven. You must know God by reading the scriptures. You get up, and all what you need, just pick your phone, and then you check whether somebody has called you. All what you need to know is you pick your phone, and then you browse. You begin to browse. That is why we don't know God. We know church, but we don't know God. We know the pastor, but we don't know God. So if you want to develop an attitude of a winning person, you must know God personally. As you begin to develop relationship with God, you will grow spiritually, you will grow physically, you will grow mentally, you will grow academically. As you are seeking God, as you are reading your Bible, every day, you are knowing God, you are seeking God, you will grow spiritually, you will know many things. Understanding, you got wisdom, you got knowledge, you got many things. As you are reading the scriptures, you know God. You know God. You know God. You know God. All scriptures is given by God's inspiration and is profitable for doctrine. It is profitable. So once you are seeking God, it is a profitability of knowing God as the. As you are reading the scriptures, you are knowing God. And when we say that it is profitable, it is profitable. It means that when you get up and you go to work, it is profitable. Because at the end of the day, they will give you money. And when we say that, as you also begin to read the scriptures, it is profitable. It is profitable for your healing. It is profitable for your success. It is profitable for your promotion. It is profitable. Therefore, know God personally. Know God intimately. By reading the scriptures, by understanding the scriptures, by going through the scriptures, and as you do that, you know Him. How do you know God? By understanding what He has written. At times, your beloved will write you a letter, will text you a message, and the message is so sweet that when you get up, you just pick it and you read it. And as you are reading it, you are knowing the person more. You are developing love. You are developing intimacy. You want Him to write you more. But God has given us so much in the scriptures.
Amen.
I am so glad that my Father in heaven tell of His love in the book He has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. It is the tears that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that my Father in heaven tell of His love in the book He has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. It is the tears that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction. So that is why you need to know God. Because as you are reading it, the word will correct you. The word will correct your life. The word will correct your mistakes. The word of God will tell you many things. The word will speak to you. The word will come to you. In fact, you know many things as you are approaching into the word. It says that for instruction in righteousness. If you don't know God as you are reading scriptures, how will you know the instruction for righteousness? You will just get up and you will be going to disco. Because you know that it is out of righteousness. You get up and you will be fornicating. You get up and you will be drinking. You get up and you will be doing all sorts of things. You get up and you begin to insult how children are fighting with their parents in our days now because they don't read the scriptures. They don't know God intimately. You get up and you insult your father. You get up and you insult your mother. You get up and you begin to fight because you don't have intimacy. You don't have personal relationship with God by reading the scriptures. But if you read the scripture, you know that children obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. If you want to know God, if you want to know God, you must read your Bible. And as you are reading the Bible, you begin to know many things. And that is why Bible said the youth will continue to fall down because they fail to understand how to know God. All what they know is to come to church. All what they know is to dress up. And that is why there is divorce. That is why there is quarreling. That is why there is confusion. That is why there is chaos. That is why there are powers of darkness that has invaded the church. Why? Because we don't know God personally as we read the scriptures.
You don't know God. You don't know God. That a man of God may be perfect. It means that when you read the scriptures, you become perfect. You become perfect.
Totally finished. It means that you be a finished Christian. You become perfect. Not only perfect, you be a finished. Something that God has taken his time to finish you, to renew you. God has meaning you. God has programmed you. God, in fact, your life will become so finished. Use it, please, that anybody that will come close to you, the person is so happy because you are so finished. So people will like you, people will love you. What is the meaning of finished? Something that is completed, something that is accurate, something that is nice. As you begin to read the scripture, you become perfect. You become perfect in your marriage. You become perfect in success.
Amen.
You become perfect in academic. You become perfect and you become finished.
Amen. To the hands of the master.
Amen.
Yeah. So you have to know God personally to read the scriptures. If these words will sound into your spirit, you know that 3 months from now, there will be a change over your life. If you can allow these things to sound into your spirit, by 3 months from now, then I want to know God. Every day you come to church and the pastor will say, open to, open here, open to. When will you also say, it is written up? When the devil came to Jesus, Jesus responded to the devil that it is written, it is written, it is written. When will you also sit down and say it is written? In John chapter 1 verse 1, in the beginning was the word. Everything is from the word. Everything is the word. The beginning is the word. Getting up is the word. Going down is the word. Rising up is the word. In the beginning was the word. And the word was the God. Everything in the beginning, 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 in relationship. Bible is the first. In academic, Bible is the first. The word is the first. In your marriage, the word is the first. In your business, the word is the first. In your social life, the word is the first. In the beginning was the word. No God. No God. No God. Number 2. To have a wedding. If you don't know God through reading scripture, they will give you something to drink and tell you that this is a direction from God. They will just tell you something. And then they will, something that you end up being divorced because you are not knowing God through scriptures. Number 2. If you want to win, I want to have a successful attitude. You must become obedient to God and love Him. If you want to become a winning person, because life is a race, and not everybody that are in church will be winning in life because they will not understand or they will not cleave their ears to what we are saying. If you want to be a successful person, all what you need to know, all what you need to do is to begin to become obedient and begin to love God. Remember that Bible said that someone is mine, God is mine. Your marriage is in the hands of God. Your blessings is in the hands of God. Your healing is in the hands of God. Your prosperity is in the hands of God. Therefore, begin to become obedient to Him. Begin to love Him so that you can have a successful life. Everything is in the hands of God. He got the whole.
He got it home.
He got it home.
He got it home.
in the scriptures. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Somebody's husband, they come to church, but there is no peace in them. Why? Because they think that as they are sacrificing,
God will hear their prayer. That is why I say, become obedient, be a lover.
So Samuel was talking to Saul. Say, Saul, do you think that God is so happy with your burnt offering? Do you think that God is so happy with your offerings? And because of the offering, we shouldn't talk about you. Because of your offering, you want to be the boss of the church. Because of your offering, you want to become a CEO. Because of your offering, you want to control pastor. Because of your offering, you want to control the word of God. Who told you that God is interested with your offering and with your sacrifice? Bible says that to obey is better than sacrifice.
I will never be the same again. I will never return.
Preaching doesn't mean that you are obedient. I come being a house has nothing to do with obedience. Coming to church with your shoe, coming to church with your nice dress has nothing to do with obedience. You may be a Christian, but you are not obedient. You are a rude, you are a proud person which is ready to go to hell. In Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 21. Saith the Lord, the God of hosts of Israel, put your burnt offerings unto your sacrifice and eat your flesh. In other words, God said, I take your offering and go. You are too proud of yourself. So even coming to church, the offering that you are coming, you are too proud that you want everybody to see. That is like you are too proud as you are coming into the house of the Lord. You want everybody to see you in a way of kindness. And then you think that you are becoming obedient. Bible says that take away your offering, take away your sacrifice. If you better take it and go. If you take it and eat your flesh, eat your own food, eat your own whatever, eat it. Bible says that, for I spent not unto your fathers, nor commanded them in the day that I brought them from the land of Egypt. Concerning burnt offering, it means that when I bring, when I brought your fathers, when I brought them from Egypt, I didn't speak to them about offering. I didn't speak to them about sacrifice. But verse 23, it says that, but this thing commanded I them, saying, obey my voice. It means that God commanded them to obey his voice. People think that as they are praying their time, as they are coming to church, as they are dancing, they are obeying God. Your 2 hours, you are obeying God. We are talking of obedience. Your 2 hours has nothing to do with obedience with God. If you want to obey God, you obey God 24 hours, in 7 days, in 1 month, in the whole year, all your lifestyle, you begin to obey God. You don't obey God on Sunday, and that Sunday is only 2 hours, and this same person tells you that God is blessing him. Shame on you all. Your obedience has nothing to do with your sacrifice. We have people who are eloquent. When I'm acting, they can put the exegesis and then put the antonyms and synonyms together. And then they have hermeneutics and homiletics. And they begin to combine the exegesis. And they begin to eschatologize the message and to the PowerPoint. And then they do, and they think that they are becoming obedient. But that obedience has nothing to do with sacrifice. Obedience has nothing to do with your BBC English, with your Jezebel English. Then you tone your voice in a way as if God is coming down.
Hey.
But it just came from your best house.
Hey.
You understand and say, obedience, very, very important. But this thing, command I them, obey my voice, and I will be your God. It means that if you can obey God, and how to obey God, the first point is very important. To obey God is engage yourself in the scriptures. It is the scripture that will make you know God. It is the scripture that will make you, it is the scripture that will make you know everything. It's not going to be physics. Your school teacher can never help you to know God. Doing chemistry, has you can never know God through studying chemistry. Studying Greek, studying tree, of what has nothing to do to obey God. As you're studying the business, and then as you're studying the engineering, and then the computer scientist, it has nothing to know God. The only way to know God is to go close to the written words of Jesus, the words that has been written. You can go, you have to go into the letter of the person, and God has put all what he wants us to know in the book. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. And you shall be my people, and walk ye in all the ways that I have commanded you, that it may be well unto you. So if you want things to be well with you, ladies and gentlemen, if you want things to be well with you, you have to become an obedient to God and to love him. What did Jesus tell his disciples? He said that if you love me, obey my commandment. It means that if you love me,
be obedient to me. So we are moving around, but nobody is obedient. We are nobody love God. We live in a hypocritical environment, hypocritical ministry. That the person will be coming, a person is shaking as if Holy Ghost has come. Look, all these things are generating. It's flesh. It's not love. There's no obedience. What God says, you are not doing it. The day God told you to fast, that was the day you ate. The day God woke you up in the middle of the night to pray, that was the day you slept most. And you say that I pay tithe, I pay offering. Hey! He says that, obey my voice. The Bible is the voice of God. There are more than 15 voices that are in the world to speak to distract you from God. And the one that can get you closer is the voice of the Bible. The Bible is the voice that once you read it, you begin to become obedient. One of the reasons of our suffering in our days is disobedience. We are so disobedient in our life, and that's why we keep on suffering. And this same person will come to church and cry, say they don't know why. Tonight, this morning, the word of God is coming. He says that, be a lover of God, become obedient to his word. And as you are becoming obedient, you know the hope of your calling. Number three, I'm talking to you about the success, the attitude of a way, how to develop it, how to develop your attitude. How to develop your attitude as a pastor's wife? How to develop your attitude as a pastor? How to develop your attitude as a church member? So that you can win. You can win in life. You can win in the race. You can win in the journey. Don't just come to church and sit down. Open your understanding. Get wisdom. Don't just come and just be playing drums. Get understand. Don't just come and sit down. I go to church to play organ. I go to church to sing. It is not obedience. It's an activity in church, and that is why we keep on suffering. So get into the word of God, get understanding, get to know what you are saying. Let your mind come on it, get it, and it shall be well with you. Yes. The last verse is that so that it shall be well with you, yes. So that it shall be well with you, yes. It shall be well in any area, anything that you are doing, it shall be well with you. I remember when we were growing up. We drank church, we ate church, we swim church, we play church. People were laughing at us. People thought that we were mad. People thought that there's something wrong in the brain here. But we sought for God early of our days, praying, seeking His face, breaking the curses in our family. Breaking the barriers and the bondages in your family. Try to climb into an area where God has positioned us. Because when I look back and I look at the family I'm coming from, I saw that the only hope of my life is to seek God, to know God. People thought that we're mad. We're loving God. We're breathing God. We're dancing God. We're jumping. We eat God. In the morning we eat God. Why? So that it shall be well with us. We are talking of obedience. We remember having money for offering, but you still see us praying. We remember having big things for big sacrifice, but all what God was requiring is to become obedient. We become obedient, loving God. Become obedient, loving God. Become obedient. Who told you that your money is a substitute of obedience? No. And this is how far God has brought us. I could have been a rich smoker. I could have been jumping from woman to woman. I could have been doing bad things if I did not seek Him. There are many things I could have done. When I look at myself, I could see the picture of my life. That this is what you could have become. But see that so that it shall be well with you. I'm talking to young boy, that young girl now. If you want it to be well with you, know God. If not, your life will become useless. You'll be smoking. You'll be a weed smoker. You'll be a drug addict. You'll be a drug addict. And that is why people are in charge. They smoke. They are drug addicts. You'll be a smoker. You'll be a drunkard.
your life will be a street boy. Your life will be useless if you don't seek God. Who told you that education can take you away from it? Who told you that education can take you? If you don't seek God, your prayer will be taken away from you. Based on the family you come from, based on the region you come from, and based on what your mother and your father have done before, based on what they have done before, and how they gave birth to you. If you don't seek God, talking to that young boy, talking to that sister, talking to that man, that if you need for it to be well with you, no God. If God will be a disappointed to your husband, you'll be a disappointed to your mother, you'll be a disappointed to your father, you'll be a disappointed to God because you didn't seek God. You sought for marijuana, you sought for India hemp, you sought for alcohol, you sought for parliament, you sought for confusion. But we said that obey my voice. I brought you from Egypt. Not, I didn't speak to you with burnt offering. I didn't speak to you with offerings. I didn't speak to you with your sacrifice. But I told you that obey my voice so that it shall be well with you. Generation wants us to prophesy. One of the generations who have failed God is our generation now. Obedient to God's word. Love God. Love God. Use your heart to love. Anything that you are doing with love, you know. It's not by mouth. And that is why if you get genuine love, people quickly see it. You may try to grab, you may try to speak, but if it is not from your heart, it's just a matter of time. And that is why people are backsliding, because they thought that they could come to church with their energy. Without the love of God, you can't travel. Without the love of God, you can't be. Any person you love, anything you love, you give addiction to. Anything you love, you spend time. Anything you love, you try. That is why you love Facebook, so you can be on Facebook. That is why you love home theater, home video. So that is why you can be on home video for 2 hours, because you love it. Anything you love, you give your heart. Anything you love, you spend time. Anything you love. So if I say you don't love God, you have to understand. When was the last time you prayed 1 hour? When was the last time you read the scriptures 1 hour? When was the last time you spent time in the spirit, in the presence of the Lord? When was the last time that you took the flyers and you said, I am not for evangelism. I am not for evangelism for 2 hours. I am not for evangelism for 3 hours. When was the last time you prayed 3 hours? When was the last time you prayed 7 hours? When was the last time you spent 5 hours engaging the scriptures? When was the last time you get up in the morning with your shirt, you put on your makeup, you put on your eyelash, you put on your earring, you put on your shoe? You are too proud as you come into the house of God. No obedience. You don't love God. You don't obey God. But you are a sure person, a sure preacher, a sure member, a sure teacher, a sure pastor, a sure prophetess, a sure pastor's wife, a sure member, a sure presence leader, a sure organist, a sure. You are a sure person. Don't love God. Am I communicating to somebody? Don't love God. Anything you love, give your heart. Give your heart. And if you fail to do what the scripture says, you'll be a disappointment to your life. May you run the race. May you run through the truth. In the name of Jesus. And the spirit power in your life, and the power tie in your destiny. In the name of Jesus, I loose you from the bond of the devil. I loose you from the bondage of the devil. In the name of Jesus, anything that is causing you not to love God, but shout the word, say the word, and the thing pressure in your life to take your love, to take your joy from the presence of God. This morning I crash it back. This morning I crash it down. This morning I crash it down. This morning I crash it down. Shout fire! In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. God wash you with his blood. God wash you with his blood so that you can love him. God made you become a Christian so that you may love him. What is making you not to love God? What is taking away your heart? The other day, Apostle Paul was speaking, and he said that in the last days, the ruler's time will come. People shall be lovers of money. People shall be conducive. People shall give heed to doctrines. follow righteousness, follow purity, follow holiness. That is going to help you. What is dissociating your life? What is distracting your life away from the love of God? Today, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your heart. I pray for your body. I pray for your spirit. May you come back. 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 May you come back.
Proverbs 29. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs 29. Let's say something. Proverbs 29, verse 18 says that where there is no fishing, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he. So where there is no fishing, where there's no burning desire, people will continue to perish. To perish means that you will not be successful. To perish means that you will never get there. You have to have a burning desire. That I remember one lady, he said that if they will not allow me to preach, I will do strict evangelism. Because there is a burning desire in the person. Because they don't want the person to preach in public. So she will just go into the street and begin to preach. Why? Because there is a burning desire. If there is a burning desire, there is no barrier. Because your life is in the hands of God. Your destiny is in the hands of God. And through you, many will be saved. Through you, people will be saved. Therefore, when there is no vision, you will be perishing. But I pray for you this morning that may you never perish. May you never perish. May you never perish. May you never perish. May your vision come to pass. Have a burning desire. A burning desire. When you have a burning desire, when a man is having a burning desire for a lady, he can travel for 70 miles. He can travel for people even by plane. They buy ticket travel because of a burning desire for a lady or for a man. I remember recently I was in the airport and they said that we can never enter because we bought a ticket of the plane is full, but there's another one. Reserve ticket. We bought a reserve ticket. So we were there, we were fine. And then and they put us waiting list. So we're in the airport. The people were entering. People were entering. So it's like the people who couldn't enter, some people will cancel their ticket. So the people who cancel their ticket, then they will put the reserve us, the reserve ones. So we're there. When they say that it has not with two people, but we were five. I saw one lady tears. The lady was crying. The lady was crying. He said that I have a boyfriend. I miss this boyfriend for 6 months. Please, can you please let me in? As the lady was crying, we were all also feeling sad for this lady. She was crying. Why? Because she was having a burning desire to go and see somebody. Maybe who will not marry her? A burning desire. The lady was crying. I said, God, when I was coming, I said, me too, I should have cried. I'm a pastor. I want to go and preach. But the way the lady was crying, you could see the burning desire. So anytime you have a burning desire, you do something extraordinary. It changes everything. Anything you have a burning, anytime you have a burning desire, this that you do is you become mad. People will not see you as a normal person because there is a desire inside you. There is a burning inside you that you want to reach there. You want to become a doctor. You want to become an engineer. You want to become a pastor. You want to become a prophet. You want to become an apostle. Therefore, there is a burning desire. I can't sleep. I have to rise up and pray. I can't sleep. I have to fast. I have to engage the scripture. I have to begin to meditate and think. Why? Because there is a burning desire. When there is no vision, I used to tell people, I want to will not let you get there. I want to do this. You will never get there. People who are like that, you will never get there. It takes a spirit of a burning desire to drag you there. Because so far as your body and your flesh is concerned, you can never enter where God wants you to be. Psalm 69. Let's read it. Pastor Abandon. Psalm 69. Thank you, Lord. Are you blessed?
Yes.
Yeah. Psalm 69. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 9.